being really depressed and not knowing why I feel the way that I do and having no motivation for life, just unhappy, I think. And I don't think it was necessarily because I transitioned. I think I was just really confused.
You know what she did? Your canting daughter!
What's gonna happen to them? Kids and the youth, and there's so many people who regret this.
Fuck you! Jesus, fuck you! Please, fuck you!
I've got a weird thing going on where I've got complete areas of numbness and then hypersensitivity of pain. So you can like, nothing. Ah, that hurts. Oh my God, what are you doing? That means that having sex of any kind is very difficult.
Look at me, Damien. It's all for you.
Her need to play boy roles and her need to be seen or spoken to as a boy at home became very persistent and very consistent. Those are the hallmarks of a possibly transgender child. Consistence, persistence, and insistence. And she was meeting all those markers.
Pediatrician Dr. Michelle Forcier says gender identity is formed very early.
It's not a fad or a phase. And I tell parents that even though they may feel or want to believe that. Your four-year-old probably knew that they were a boy or a girl at, you know, 3, 4, 5 years old, and that's a normal part of child development.
Well, good morning. This story, at its heart, is about challenging the limits of human possibility, how we think, how we live, how we love. And the way the two women we're about to meet live and love could change the way you think about your own future. Our story begins with two women who've been in love for 35 years, Martine and Bina Rothblatt.
My main purpose in life is enjoying every day with Bina.
Now Martine Rothblatt is taking on the biggest challenge of all, the limits of human life. In her new book, Virtually Human, Martine explains her plan to clone the human mind, breaking down specific thoughts and emotions into computer code.
We're talking about crossing some line from technology to human.
We're pointing out that humanhood can transcend software, just like love can transcend skin tone, love can transcend gender.
Mayo Clinic in Rochester began performing female gender affirmation surgeries last year. Since then, nearly 200 people have undergone the irreversible transformation. Mayo is one of a few hospitals in the country that offers such a surgery.
While preps were being made this morning for the Pride Parade, Governor J.B. Pritzker was signing an executive order at Lakeview High, that piece of paper creating a task force that will work on best practices for Illinois' transgender and gender-neutral students.
And it's, there's so many interesting facets and issues to doing this.
Jesus, Son of the Most High God. What do you want with me? I beg you, don't punish me.
What is your name?
My name is Legion, for we are many.
Oh, and what pronouns are they and them?